pan and zoom. So this is kind of a cool feature. Now I've shown you how to do it right with the two fingers from the hand tool. But let's do it straight from the zoom tool on the bottom. So if I click this magnifying glass, right, it says 95% is where we're at now. I could say reset and it'll take me to 100, right? But then what I do, one finger will move me around canvas. So if I want to kind of make it some sort of a linear timeline, I could do this, and I'm just moving around canvas. Two fingers, right, pinches and zooms. Starry Night, look at that, cool, right? And so that's two fingers. All of those actions will be recorded when you do it this way. If I was recording this, they would all be recorded and it would all be seen if I'm giving a presentation that way. That leads me to the next one, stealth mode. With stealth mode, what it does is allows me to kind of have, I could zoom in real close and do something that's really precise, or I could zoom out and I could actually have something like this that would be off the screen, not unseen, and I could just bring it in all of a sudden, or bring things in and out, right? So that they would kind of make kind of a puppet show feel, right? Or a felt board, if you will. I really like using that. I like having this red frame because it's, again, it's only whatever's in that red frame is what's going to be seen or recorded for your presentation. So you could have, it's good to maybe even have text. So let's try one that I had text in here. All right, cool. So I'm going to enter this one and I'm going to go to, I'm in stealth mode. All right, now I could use it the same way I've been using everything, right? Maybe what I want to have is that out and I can bring that in as I want, right? So I can be talking about text. You could talking about text, I could then also bring that in, right? Look at the sky. And Joshua Tree was not this image, so it wouldn't make sense. But anyways, you could bring things in from different directions. I really like doing that when I'm making videos or I'm making some sort of explanation. Having stuff that I could just easily swipe in on the go. All right, now I've been playing, then reset, as you saw, will take you just back to that frame that you can see, or the starting frame. Depending on the settings, you can actually change what the frame looks like. So, but I'll get into that when we get to our settings. All right, slide sorter, which is down here. I've been hitting it. I can go over slides, right, with these carrots. I could also use the slide sorter. What I could also do is if I want to change the order, I could hold down and just move. I just long held, move it around. I could duplicate things. So say I wanted to duplicate with recording and without recording, right? So do I want that video that I already did? I'm going to say without. So that could be good, especially if you want your students to just, you want to model something and you want your students to replicate it. You could do that. You could delete slides. Multiple at once. This is, like I said, also where you change the background to maybe something different. Say I want it to be this kind of a gray. I could do that. But again, it does it for all of your slides. So just know that. This one would be remove recording. So for example, this, let's just say I want to get rid of that recording. Current slide. And then that way it's there. It's an easy way instead of having to go back and to the timeline, go to the front and say delete from here on. You don't have to do that. You can do it from your slide sorter. The plus sign, which you've probably seen me using, is it essentially will add a new slide right after the slide you were on. So again, you can cut things in and out that way. Now, if I go back to the top bar, just as I kind of go back and wrap up some of these options, right? As I said, the left carrot up here will take you back to the home page, which I didn't necessarily need to do, but I'm going to go back anyways. All right, here where it says Untitled, this is where you would just change the name. So this would be my explain everything video that I'm making. And then what I can do is quick save or duplicate it there. So I like to quick save from there. Share is good. So go to export. And so you can choose to share things as video and shares them straight to device or cloud service, whichever you want to do. Document, right? So that would save it as a PDF. Image would be right, save your image. Like I usually recommend to save it to your photos, right, directly on your device, but you could also do it on save to files. And then also we could save the entire project, right? So you could create something, and then you can upload it to like a learning management system, and then have your students download it, and then they could work from what you've already started. So that could be a really handy way to kind of do a lesson using Explain Everything. And the students can stay mostly within Explain Everything. That'd be a good reason to use right over here when we talked about the video overlay. You could throw in a link there and how students would use it from sharing it as a project. Now look at the bottom, see how it says 14 of 14. I'll click that. I could choose which slides I want them to actually export, video, photo, or the whole project, right? So I don't have to have them do all of them. I could just say deselect, and I just want these three, four slides, right? And I could then just choose go back. It says 4 of 14 selected, then I send them that way. All right. And then these arrows going right are to minimize the top, give you more space.